Slice and splice are the array methods which often gets confused. Let's check what they are and how to remember them in this video. Without further delay, let's get started. Slice method returns new array, which contains the portion of original array based on start and end parameters. These are just positions, and one thing to remember here is end position is excluded. Let's try with an example. We have an array of A, B, C, D. Let's slice it. Okay. Start is at 0 and end with 2. The positions are 0, 1, 2, 3. Slice also supports negative index. It's from the right to left. 0 position is here. Okay. It need to be start from the start of the 0 position. And 2 is at the start of second index. If you apply slice, okay, it gives A and B. So it returns A and B, and the original array is A, B, C, D. The original array didn't get mutated. Instead of 0 and 2, you can also apply minus 4 and minus 2. It gives the same result. Splice method returns new array which contains portion of the original array. Original array gets mutated. You can do push and pop here. I used to remember this. If there is P, you can do push and pop. You can add and remove items using splice. The first parameter is index, which tells where to start. Delete count helps to remove the items based on the count. Item 1 to item x, where you can add multiple items. Delete count can be referred with pop and items can be referred with push. Let's try with the same example. We have an array of A, B, C, D. Let's apply splice 0, 2, and A. So this means it's starting from 0th position, removing 2 items, and adding an item called A. Okay, 0 is starting from here. And we need to remove 2 items. Okay, 1, 2. Okay, these 2 items get removed. Splice has been applied. And we get A and B as output. And now the original array becomes C and D. Okay, we have one more thing. Item A, it needs to be pushed to this array, right? At the 0th position. Okay, now A gets added to this array. Now the original array becomes A, C, D.